Black Hippie Radio here on Spreaker.com. I am your host, the Black Hippie, and I want to thank y'all for tuning in on this Sunday. It's 9:15 in Chicago. Temperature right now at about 64 degrees. We're going to have a high 80 today. So, you know, it's going to be cloudy. A little bit of sun going to peek out every once in a while, but you know, it's going to be a nice day. Had some rain yesterday and shit, so, you know how that go. After the rain comes the sun. Man, I hope everybody been enjoying their weekend, man. I've been doing my best to enjoy mine. I've been having a lot of things come up, but you know, true players adapt. They adapt to their environment and their surroundings. Like I say, got a high 80 degrees today. What are we going to talk about? We're going to talk about the 10-year anniversary. A little tongue tied. 10-year anniversary of Hurricane Katrina. We're going to talk about this guy. He robbed the bank. The insurance company cut his daughter off. She was going through cancer and chemotherapy for her eye. It was a certain type of eye cancer. I'm going to get him more information. Talk more about that. And he go and rob the bank to get the money just for his daughter to, you know, to survive. So I found that story very, very deep and very touching. So I'm going to talk more about that. Going to talk about the Derrick Rose rape allegations, you know. This will be the first and only time you hear me talk about it because I feel like it's bullshit. But anyway, you know, we're going to talk about some more things. Talk about the Bears, you know, how bad their offense look. You know, we're going to talk about some of the positive things. We got a touchdown off the special teams, so we're going to talk more about that. Talk about the Sox and the Cubs. The Sox had the Mariners yesterday and the Cubs had the Dodgers. So we're going to talk a little bit about that, and we're going to let you listen to some of this dope music. Plus, I'm going to talk about what Black Hippie Radio Entertainment got in store. Black Saturday, which is every Saturday. Talk about Thirsty for Thursday Comedy Showcase, how Mojo and AV just blew the roof off that motherfucker, you know, and it was a packed room, so it was very dope. So we're going to talk more about that and how y'all can come out and see them live and, you know, just everything else. Like I say, this is a Black Hippie Radio Entertainment production. Yo, Spreaker.com, man. I'm going to deliver y'all nothing but some good music and some dope talk and informing y'all of all that y'all need to know, you dig? I'll be right back at y'all. I got some J Electronica coming up. I'm going to try to put a lot of Louisiana out there. A lot of Louisianians music out there today, you know. Mix it in and mix it out. Y'all be cool. This is Spreaker.com. I'll be back in y'all at Chicago.
And they say if we'll only avoid any direct confrontation with the enemy, he'll forget his evil ways and learn to love us.
Don't worry about
it. All who oppose them are indicted as warmongers. They say we offer simple answers to complex problems. But perhaps there is a simple answer. Not an easy answer.
I got that black on black skin tone. Actual fact syndrome. That's why I dropped the jewel in every verse you heard me shit on. Okay, it's a Slumdog opera, the tale of a king whose name wasn't on the roster. My road to glory was road to perdition. And act two, the turn, is just the memoirs with no omissions. We came a mighty long way from standing near the stove in the cold. The greatest story ever told. The realest niggas see the pain in my storyboards. The true believers say, wallahi, I support the ball. My life feel like a highlight reel. This is lightning striking, feel how the zeitgeist feel. Get a slight chill.
I got these niggas breezy.
My swag is on 1.21 gigawatts, 10 trillion kilowatts, hardcore thriller pop, Michael Jackson, nigga rock. Google me, baby, understand where I'm coming from. My destiny's to hit a grand slam when my number come. All hail the lyrical, grand wizard imperial. Nigga signed a dotted line with Hov, that's a miracle. And I ain't lead the thugs alone. The humble and meek will surely inherit the mud we own and shoot up every club we clone.
Let that bitch breathe.
The flow was too atomic, the poetry's too Quranic. A young prophet Muhammad. And I could drop a verse to change the whole vibration. The whole rock nation, the whole live nation. So pour libation. Beware but prepare for the polarization. It's the globalization. Warn all the clergymen and notify Satan. I've been waiting, it's the notarization. I've been patient.
I got these niggas breezy. Don't worry about it.
1,000 kisses to the haters, cause they made me greater. 1,000 wishes from a million slaves to raise a savior. 1,000 visits to these dickheads at these major labels. From Big Daddy Kane to Big Daddy Kane and Abel. You pay a cost to be your boss, nigga. I paid the wager. Master both sides of the force. And plus I made my saber. Yes, sir. I'm a soldier of love. Drowning all my sorrows and woes in the club. My white boys say that shit you spit last year, bro, was like a real fine Merlot when the cashmere throw. Some black chicks say he ugly. White women, they love me. My Asians and my mommies don't put nothing above me. I call it as it happened, the art of quality rapping. One autobiographical chapter could start up the rapture. And even though I walk in the narrow valley of death, all I see is green pastures, bitches screaming from the rafters.
I got these niggas, Breezy. Don't worry about it.
Black Hippie Radio Entertainment, man. That's how you kick off the show with a little bit of electronica, you dig? Man. And I'm gonna be backing y'all on a consistent basis, man. If this don't get y'all pumped on the Sunday, I don't know what will, man. Got something else coming up for y'all. Lil Wayne Glory. Here it is.
Flying confidentials, that's private. Tell a pilot, be quiet, we need our privacy. Throw you off this bitch if you want it, justifiably. Hustle with a motive, you notice I'm with my waters. No snakes, no rodents, no ad-libs, no chorus. No stress, no worries, took you to a respiratory. It's self-explanatory, the glory is mandatory. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Holy shit, I can't hold this shit. My bowels looser, my towers newer. My powder room is for powder users. You see rolled up dollar bills filled with snot and mucus. My tires Lucas, my driver's cruising. My partner's ruthless, my flowers ruthless. My pocket's ruthless, she carving Rufus. I'm not a student, I'm not assuming. I'm not a human, you are not immune to this kind of music. You got him, don't you? You got him, don't you?
Hope y'all enjoying the show so far. Don't worry about it, Wayne. I got him right now on the mic, man. That was a dope track, man. I hope Wayne get back on track. Well, not hope, he is gonna get back on track. You know, before I got off the mic and got into the music, talking about the guy, they say robbed the bank down there in, let me see, where was that? He was in Michigan. And his name Brian Randolph, 23 years old, from Michigan. Said he stands accused of robbing a credit union down in Michigan to pay for his daughter's chemo treatments. His daughter has a rare eye disease. And say he faces charges of armed robbery, and his bond is $500,000. Now, he had no gun, he passed a note and everything else, so it was a non-violent act. But, you know, my thing is that, you know, let me just read it. No, they say Randolph demanded $20,000. He managed to escape the credit union with $8,000 in cash. Police say it was his poor disguise that gave him away. They tracked him down within 2 days after posing an appeal for information on Facebook. Now my whole thing is like, you know, I'm asking you, what would you do? Is he wrong? Is he deserving of what he got? I don't think he is. So this is Black Hippie Radio's pledge to raise money for this guy. You know, to bond him out of jail. You know, this is what these white folks did. You know, not to be said like that, but they did it for Zimmerman. They also did it for the, you know, this other police officer, you know, the guy that killed him. You know, it's about a time that we need to stick together, and I don't see what he did was wrong. So I'm not mad at you, man. Actually, I applaud you for stepping up and doing what a man do. But, you know, the type of world we live in. $500,000 bond for trying to save a life. A life that's a piece of him. I don't get it, America. But be back in your ear, man. Like I said, this story right there, it was kind of touched me, man, you know. So y'all think about that. Go to Black. I'm gonna put that question up on the Black Hippie Radio Entertainment page. Make sure y'all go check it out. I'm gonna put that question up. What would you do in a situation like that? If it was your family member, or if it was your daughter, your son, what would you do? Go check it out. Got Currency coming up. I'm Mary, Mary, Mary. I'm Mary, Mary, Mary. Black Hippie Radio.